Hey guys, it's Victoria and welcome back to FemmeHead. Today I'm going to my menstrual cup Q&A. Where did I put that sucker? I've brought a clean, pretty much new cup. I asked you guys to ask me questions on my Monday email this week, as well as Twitter and Instagram. If you guys want to follow me or sign up for the email, I will link all that down below. But we're going to start with my email questions first, and I'm just going to sit down and try to answer all the questions. I had a couple of requests for people to remain anonymous from my emails, so I'm just not going to include anyone from there. I'm going to be looking down, so don't get mad at me for doing that. So I've always been interested in menstrual cups, also ways to be more sustainable during my period. However, last year I was diagnosed with, I'm not going to pronounce this right, vaginismus. So devices like menstrual cups or even tampons haven't really been a go-to option. Is there a menstrual cup brand out there that you recommend, or do you have any alternatives so I could have an environmentally friendly period too? Involuntary contraction of muscles around the opening of the vagina in women with no abnormalities in the genital organs. The tight muscle contractions make sexual intercourse or any sexual activities that involve penetration painful or impossible. The doctors don't know exactly why it happens. It's usually linked to anxiety and fear of having sex, but it's unclear which came first. So I guess I don't have a clear-cut answer for that. If you want something that you wear internally, I would say maybe give menstrual sponges a go, because they are very soft, easy to insert and remove. My trick is to put like a piece of string through the bottom of it so you can pull it out like a tampon, but it doesn't have the same need to insert it like a tampon in like a plastic case or something like that. So maybe a menstrual sponge is an option for you. Menstrual cups are not all the same. Some of them are more rigid and stiff than others, and I would say that a more rigid or stiff one I don't find as comfortable to insert. Some people like it more because they think it helps insert it better, but I like ones that are much more flexible. As far as flexible menstrual brands that I have tried, Lunette, Ruby Cup, Organa Cup, which is this one, I have tried also the Moon Cup, and I feel like that one's a bit more rigid. Can you talk about how to safely use a menstrual cup with an IUD? I've heard mixed messages about whether or not it's safe or if you increase the risk of moving the IUD around with the cup. I have not heard that. I wouldn't think you would have any issues of moving the IUD around. The only thing that should be hanging into your vagina from your uterus is the string that is attached to the bottom of the IUD. That shouldn't be impacted by a tampon or a cup or anything. I have heard like horror stories of IUDs getting moved around where they're not supposed to be and them doing some pretty funky stuff. From Bedsider, they said using menstrual cups and tampons with either an IUD or the ring is safe and shouldn't interfere with the effectiveness of your birth control. There is a small risk of expulsion with an IUD, but the rate of this happening to a cup user is no higher than for folks who use other menstrual products. So I think that's your answer. I haven't heard of it, but then again, I don't know, so take my answer with a grain of salt, but you should be okay with a cup. It shouldn't interfere with your IUD. It shouldn't come in contact with your IUD beyond just the string. Next question. I plan to switch to the menstrual cup to reduce my period environmental footprint, but what can I do with my everyday flow? I haven't found one single zero-waste alternative that is functional. I did try the reusable pads, but they just are too thick and they move around, so I didn't find them very comfortable. There's also period underwear, but I don't think they are meant to be worn every day. I don't know why like daily discharge has been coming up, or like daily fluid has been coming up, and I want to make a separate video about it. I'm curious, people that feel like they have an overwhelming amount of daily discharge, I'm curious how much that actually is, why they feel like it's too much to just wear underwear with, what kind of discharge it is. So if you have an experience with, or if you feel like you have an overwhelming amount of daily discharge that you feel like you need some sort of liner or something between you and your underwear, email me at victoria@femmehead.com because I want to make a video about this, and I don't have experience, and I'm curious about it. I wouldn't wear a menstrual cup for an everyday flow. Wouldn't wear a tampon either. I understand what you're saying about reusable pads. I'm not a big fan of reusable pads, but I've only tried one kind and I had the same issue where they moved around. Period underwear, on the other hand, I think would be a great option. If you feel like you're gonna ruin your normal underwear, I would also suggest like maybe just getting like a thicker pair of cotton underwear. You still want it to be very breathable. That is important, especially on like an everyday use. But I do have a couple pairs of like period underwear that are thinner. They're both by Nixwear, and they just have the slightest bit more of lining, and I will link those down below. So that might be your option, not a menstrual cup, but I would definitely recommend a menstrual cup for just your actual period. The next question is, what is your menstrual cup cleaning routine? How often do you clean it with something other than water, and what do you use? This is a good question. I feel like I had a lot of questions about cleaning menstrual cups, and I think so much so that I'm gonna make another video about it, but I'll answer the question here. So I boil my cup in between periods, and I find that that is enough to clean it and sterilize it. There is some discoloration. I don't care about that because no one sees my cup but me and maybe Michael if it's lying around. Every now and then, if I feel like there's some discoloration, I will take some baking soda and like a toothbrush and very lightly kind of scrub it, or I'll just use an old toothbrush and just scrub it where I feel like the discoloration is, and then I'll leave it to sit out in the sun. Next question, I would just like to know the pros and cons of them. Which do you prefer between the cup, pad, or tampon? So I definitely prefer the cup. There are so many pros to this. I made a video last week or 2 weeks ago about why I don't use tampons anymore. But basically I would say more eco-friendly, saves you money, creates less waste. I don't have to worry about like not having tampons bought or in my house or with me when my period starts. I just need a cup. It's easy to travel with because you don't have to bring a bunch of tampons with you. The only cons I would say is like at first, using it in public, which I'm going to talk about because there's some questions about that. It was a little awkward, but like I'm fine with it now. There are certain days where I feel like it just doesn't want to get a good seal, and so I leak more. But for the most part, I definitely choose a cup over a tampon or a pad. Do you think that the cervix height matters for first-time users? I've had extreme difficulty inserting the cup, but I know two friends who are also first-timers and got it in on the very first try, and they both seem to have low cervixes. I don't think cervix height has anything to do with like being able to use it. Cervix height will determine, or the length of your vagina will determine, whether you need to trim off the stem or have a stem. There's a learning curve to using it at first. I would definitely say give yourself 3 cycles or 3 periods to kind of get the hang of it. When it's frustrating you during that first period and can't quite seem to get it right, don't give up. Just keep going. Like, you have to learn how to use tampons. You have to learn how to use stuff. So don't give up if it doesn't work right away. The next question is, some sources say to sanitize with warm soapy water. Others say put it in boiling water. Other sources say never put plastic silicone in boiling water as it leaches the chemicals in your cup. I will sometimes boil water and then put this in the mason jar and pour the boiling water over that and just let it sit for 15 minutes. That is what every brand says to do, is just to boil your cup in between. And I think that's just the simplest solution. The next question, my biggest usage problem is leaking after reinserting it during my period. I put it in a little before my flow starts and I seem to get a good seal then. I empty it the first time, no issues. Then reinserting it always seems to miss some. I end up needing a pad, which seems to defeat the point of wearing a cup. I think part of it is some blood gets into the vaginal wall below where the cup brim would sit, but I worry I'm just not getting the placement right after the initial dry insertion. Do you ever have a problem with a mess or leaks after reinsertion, and does it come down to a fit issue? I can definitely see to where, like, when you insert it, there is going to be blood along your vaginal walls that are down here that aren't getting caught into this, so like that little bit might leak out, and that's why I choose to wear period underwear with my cups. It doesn't have to be a thick, bulky pair of period underwear. I'm gonna grab some in a second to show you guys. It could just be a pair that gives you a little bit of protection, and it is period underwear, so you're not worried about like ruining your nice day-to-day underwear. I wouldn't say it has to do anything with the seal, and I'm sure I'll get into this more with other questions, but like, regardless of what I use, and this has been the case for me since I've had my period, whether it is a sponge, whether it is a tampon, whether it is a cup, I always leak just a little bit, and usually is just enough to where it would stain my underwear. But because I choose to wear period underwear, that problem is solved, and that has been my solution to it. And I know that's not what people want to hear. They want to hear some magical fix of how to get the perfect seal, and there are plenty of videos out there about how to check the seal and how to get a proper seal, but I don't think it's necessarily that. I just think there is blood and stuff happening, and you can't necessarily catch that all with a cup or a tampon. Menstrual cups, I love the idea. I've worn mine a few times, and there's a lot I really like about it. The only thing is, sometimes when I'm feeling tender, and because my flow isn't always that heavy, I can find getting in and out quite uncomfortable. I've tried running it under a hot tap to get a little bit more flexible, as well as lube, but I can't find the process of making sure the seal is good at the start and releasing it at the end kind of uncomfortable. Also, I seem to get pinged by the cup as it twangs itself back to full shape on the way out. In short, any tips on how to getting it in and out without unnecessary discomfort? I would say giving different folds a try. I've always just had very good luck with the classic classic C shape. Better yet, link to a video to show you different folds. And so maybe if one particular fold isn't working and you find that you can't get it to pop open, maybe try a different fold. I haven't had much issues with removing it. I know exactly what you're talking about as it re-expands right as it comes out of your body. I find that almost kind of pulling it out at an angle so the whole thing's not coming out once. I don't know if this is gonna be a good description. So okay, this is the opening to your vagina. Obviously it doesn't look like that, but so instead of pulling it out all at once, I find that pulling it out kind of like this, I'm gonna over exaggerate it, so pulling it out so one end comes out first kind of helps ease it out better, and I'm very gentle with myself. So when I'm pulling it out, I pull it so the side facing my back comes out first, and I don't have any issues with spilling it or leaking, dumping it everywhere. I have never dumped my cup everywhere. I haven't had that issue. I find that inserting a dry cup isn't pleasant. Okay, so inserting it, I use a classic C fold, and I kind of use this bit, and that is the part that goes into my body first. I also find that what works best, I will always, you know, rinse it out in sink, keep it kind of wet, but like not dripping, not have any water inside of it or anything like that. Put it in my C fold. I'll put this curve up to my vagina. I will sometimes like swirl it around the opening a little bit. Very graphic, I know, but so it picks up some moisture, it picks up some blood, because your menstrual blood is like the perfect lubricant to then slide it into your vagina very easily. And that is what I found works best for inserting it. Next question. I've been using a cup for about a year and a half, and no matter how many different cups I try, I always somehow leak in the first 1 to 2 days of my cycle. As far as I can tell, my technique is correct and I'm getting a seal every time. Have you encountered this issue? Yes, like I said, I leak every single time, and it's not a lot, but it's enough to, I don't want to ruin my nice underwear, and you don't either, none of us do, and that is why I wear either black underwear. I have a few thicker pairs of like black cotton underwear that I know I'm not going to leak through that day, but I also don't want to stain pretty pink underwear or something like that. And then I also have different pairs of period underwear depending on the flow of my cycle that day. Next question, have you tried the new Intimina that is shaped like the old Instead disposables? I don't know what either of those are. I have seen and heard of the disposable menstrual cups that are more like discs. They're not shaped like this. I've never tried them. I don't have an interest to try them because they're not reusable. So no, I haven't tried that and I haven't heard of it. I'm sorry. Next question. I tried the cup a few times, two sizes from the same brand. Each time it has been kind of leaking, and the last time it was very painful, like bad menstruation pain, and I kind of fainted and couldn't get up until I removed it. Ooh, really bad and traumatic experience. I saw on the internet that the cup can push a nerve or something like that. I'm not sure it is true, and I'm wondering if I should try a very flexible one to avoid it. Does any brand have a more flexible one? So first off, I don't know what kind of cup you used. I would say definitely try one from a different brand. The ones that I find most flexible are Lunette, Ruby Cup, and Organa Cup. The Moon Cup was a bit too rigid for me, but then again, people like having a rigid cup. There are times where I'm like super, super crampy when I go to like reinsert it, and like it doesn't feel nice, but it doesn't hurt, and I've definitely never fainted. That sounds like an awful experience. And I have not heard of it hitting a nerve. Doesn't mean it doesn't exist, but I also haven't heard of like that happening with tampons either. So I don't have an answer to that, but yeah, try out a different flexible one. How do you use one in public restrooms? Also, my cup is stiffer than expected, which can make it hard to remove. Any advice on that? Cups are always a little bit stiffer at first when you first get them, and they break in as you use them more, but over time it will become less stiff. You can always try a different brand as well if you find that that one is too stiff. I don't enjoy stiff cuffs either. Public restrooms. So I was intimidated by this at first as well, but it is not difficult. A, it's nice because you already have your period product with you because it is inside of you, so you don't have to worry about bringing in tampons, bringing in a bag, fiddling with like opening a wrapper or anything like that. So how I use it in a public restroom with like stalls, and then outside the stalls are the sinks. So you don't have access to the sink while you're changing your cups. This is what I do. There's other options, I'm sure, and I will talk about some of those options. I literally pull it out, dump it into the toilet, and then put it back into me. Don't rinse it or anything like that. I just put it back into me. And some people might think that's gross, but like, it's not. Once it is back inside of me, I will take a little bit of toilet paper and I'll wipe off my fingers because they are bloody because you are on your period and you're fiddling with your vagina and it is bloody. Throw that into the toilet, flush that all, and then I will open the stall with like my wrist or something like that I haven't touch my vagina with, and then I'll go and wash my hands in the sink, and it's not a big deal. I've never had an issue with that in between of dumping it and reinserting it and then washing my hands. If you want other options, you could also have some sort of like water bottle with you in the stall, and I've used this before in an outhouse while camping. Take a water bottle with you, and that way you can rinse it out, and then you can kind of like rinse off your fingers and wipe them off. It just depends on like what you're comfortable with. That's how I use it in public. I thought I had a question on there, but it's gone. So we're gonna go to Instagram.